Dear students, it is our third class in Economics 10th, and in this class we have to study about the remaining topics under chapter Development. Students, in Economics, this first chapter, Development, is very familiar to us. We have discussed earlier. As we have studied in the previous classes, that development is part and parcel with everyone. This is a notion or idea of everyone. It is because everyone who is working anywhere has his or her own developmental idea or notion. Whether he is a farmer or a teacher, everyone has some ideas regarding development in his life. So it can't be separated from human life or from human activities, because everyone is attached to development, is attached to economic activities. And whenever we are talking about economic activities, we are talking about our progress. Yes? And whenever we are active in any field, we have an aspiration to do better, to earn better. Anyway, the remaining topics today are going to be discussed, and in this class the first topic of study here is public facilities. Students, whenever we are talking about public facilities, we are talking about basic needs of life. In our surroundings, out of surroundings, on the small level, at a larger scale also, we always see some basic facilities which are necessary for our life and development. Here also, students, we feel and need public facilities such as fresh drinking water, sanitation, fresh air, electricity, roads, educational institutions, healthcare facilities and centers, and so on. Because they are greatly linked to our life. Our life is impossible without all these facilities. So these are all public facilities because they fulfill public needs. Public facilities are very necessary to us. And these are basic requirements of human beings. That is why our community as well as government work to provide public facilities at first. In your book of Economics, first chapter, Development, whenever you would go through the chapter, you would get all these things inside the chapter. Because these public facilities are the first priority of the government and the first need of human beings. So it doesn't matter where we are living, in the urban areas or in the rural areas, we need public facilities everywhere. And this is our duty, to have public facilities This is our rights also to avail public facilities, and the duties of the government is also there to provide these public facilities to us. So public facilities are necessary things to cover up our life, to fulfill needs of our life and society, because without public facilities we can't imagine about our life. How it is possible for us to imagine our life without water, without air, without roads, without educational institutions, without health facilities? It is quite impossible. So students, public facilities are the facilities which cover up our needs and are essential things for our life, for the life of communities and nation also. Now, a very important topic is here, that is sustainability of development. This word sustainability of development is too much important to us. We are not only talking about development. Development is another thing, but sustainable development is another thing. It is because whenever we are talking and thinking about sustainability of development, we are thinking or talking about proper use and careful use of natural resources, protection of environment, and just to save some of the resources, conventional sources as well as non-conventional sources of resources for the future needs. It is because in the process of development we have almost forgotten about how we can use the resources. We are indiscriminately using the resources of the earth. So students, this is so bad. Imagine if we don't have non-conventional sources of energy, and if we have only conventional sources of energy such as coal, petroleum, natural gases, etc. What can be the life period of these resources? In this very process or continuous use of resources by our sides? Students, that is why there is a great sense to have an idea about sustainability of development, because then we would be careful about how to use the resources, how to protect the environment, and how to save some of the resources for the future generation, for the future needs. And whenever we think about all these things, we come to know that it is our moral duty just to protect some of the resources for the future needs, just to protect our environment so that it can't become polluted, and some of the resources should be kept safe. That is why there is a wiseful and careful attitude. There must be a wiseful and careful sense of the use of natural resources, so that we could secure our development as well as we could give opportunities to use the resources for the future generation, for the future needs. So sustainability of development refers to the idea of the proper and careful use of resources so that they could fulfill our needs, fulfill our developmental ideas and needs, as well as they could also fulfill the needs of the future generation. Then we would be able to protect our environment, protect our life, protect the life of the future generation. Otherwise, it is impossible. Thank you very much, students. Now we would discuss something like problems in the next class.